I think I can start, and maybe I start as long as people are moving around with some point I would like to make to the previous speaker, because I have some kind of communist education, because I was grown up in the former DDR, and communism is about who owns things, but who owns things you can touch. And free software is also, everybody knows it, but you don't lose anything if some other people have it. Yeah, and communism is you want to get something for all that you can touch. This table is of us all. And this is a very important difference between communism and free software, I think. And so maybe this is helpful in the argumentation. So, my name is Andreas Tittel, and you also said something about teaching your children. My son is this size, 22 years old. I tried to teach him at home, and he was playing in his Windows computer, but once he entered the university, he started with real work and is now using Linux for sure, because it has proven to be helpful for him. He's also studying physics, like me. I'm a physicist by profession, and I'm here because of the medical topic. The title of the talk is also Debian Med. So, but if you are really interested in medicine, I will not really, maybe I can answer your questions later on, but this talk is actually about the experiences we made in the Debian Med project and how you can apply this experience in different projects, in different fields. So, well, maybe I can entertain you a little bit about this. At first, well, I had a talk yesterday, and the first three or four slides are in common with this, because I just need to introduce the Debian Med project, but then I will go more into the detail of the concept of blends. I will tell you what blends are, and then I will present some graphs. These graphs, in my opinion, are proving that the concept of blends is a good idea if you want to make a strong team around a certain topic, if you want to reach your users, and if you want to establish, in our case, Debian, but in principle, it could also work for other distributions, to establish your distribution in a certain field of work. Well, these happy guys are mostly Debian developers, which are joined in 2001 in Bordeaux with some Bordeaux wine, and influenced by this wine, we had the crazy idea to make some project to support medical care in Debian. And as it's usual for Debian developers, they start coding right after having wine. And there was a preparation of the first talk I had about this Debian Med project, which didn't exist at this time. But in principle, the ideas were born 12 years ago in this event. So what is Debian Med? People like to think it's a practice management system. You can plug in the DVD into your computer and are ready to run for a doctor's practice. But no, it's not. Debian Med just contains a practice management system amongst a lot of other software, which is useful in different fields for medical care. We are much stronger in the preclinical research, like gene sequencing, and we can do phylogenetic trees and to find out which things which make you ill are connected or not. And so, in principle, the practice management is only one small part of you can find in Debian Med. So the right answer is Debian is a so-called pure blend for medical care and microbiology research. A pure blend is something which is preparing Debian for a certain field of work. We have Debian Science, which is more general thing for scientists. We have DB-Chem, which is preparing Debian for chemistry, so a specific science. We have Debian GIS, which is geographical information systems. We also have Debian Edu, which is for schools, which could possibly give some answers for the teacher in the previous talk. And we have other blends, which are Debian Games, Debian Multimedia, and there could be potential and way more. How do I see Debian? In principle, you have a user with a computer and wants to install a distribution. And this distribution is assembled by certain people, which I try to abstract with these smileys. And the main point is you have a certain person behind this. So if you have other distributions, you have there are persons who are doing the work, but you don't know these persons. And in Debian, you really can know these. Well, this example with WordNet was just my entry point into Debian. I'm doing way more. But in my opinion, this is a very important point, because if you know the people who are responsible for something, you can talk to them, you have a direct connection, and this makes a good feeling for you. But for the user who sees Debian the first time, it's quite confusing. You have a lot of software. You have 20,000 packages, and you will not find actually what you're using or what you want to use in Debian. And for this case, we invented the blends concept. This is just focusing your work on the packages you are interested in. So if you want to profit from the Debian network, you can immediately see what is relevant for my own work. And I will show you in the talk, or try to show you, how it is implemented. My vision of, it's not very good to see here, my vision of Debian is in kind of, if you see the area as the user space in general, and we have different blends existing in Debian, and all these blends are branching into each other, because there is some interconnection between Debian Med and DBChem, because we have also interested in chemistry and also into science. And also, all sciences are interconnected with education. And all this stuff is somehow connected, and we try to find a large user base by supporting specific fields. So for instance, if somebody is a teacher in the school and is using Debian Edu, he will use it at home as well, and I hope his friends will also be, or he will be able to convince his friends to use Debian as well. So by supporting specific fields, we could cover a lot larger user base than if we do not do this dedicated support of certain topics. Yes, what about the name? Debian Blends is a little bit uncommon name, and you can't make a lot out of it in the first place. Well, when we were sitting in Bordeaux, over Bordeaux wine, there were so-called Debian internal projects, and this was kind of fitting name, because what we are doing is internal to Debian. However, it was more applied to technical projects, how to support laptops, the networking stuff, and these technical projects were just something else than these user-oriented projects. And so somebody invented the name Custom Debian Distributions. However, this name was a total failure, because if you hear the sound Custom Debian Distributions, you immediately think that's something else than Debian, because, it's Debian customized for some purpose, but something else. And I always fight it against this wrong imagination. And when I had talks about this, the first question I was asked in the auditorium, why are you doing derivatives from Debian, even if I had large slides with its internal? So this name was a failure, and we tried to find a better name, and my suggestion was Debian Internal Solutions. And this is kind of funny in free software. If you try to change something, there people pop up, you never know, never have heard, never have provided code, but said, no, I want to have my own opinion, and this is not a good name, and we need a discussion, and we need a poll. And so we did a poll, and we then ended up in Debian Pure Blends, which is now the name. And blending means, well, like if you make coffee or so, picking the best parts of something and put it together to make something which fits your needs. And in my opinion, this name has an advantage. If you hear blends, you read the definition, what it means. If you hear custom Debian distribution, you think you know what you hear and will not read the definition. So the blends is not bad in this sense, and so I'm talking about blends. Well, there is something comparable in Fedora, for instance. They have 6 special interest groups, which is basically the same. And there is Fedora Medical SIG. And this Medical SIG is basically doing very similar things like we, but they are not such a large team, and they have way less packages. But I'm working together with these people by just reading their mailing list, and if I see they are working on some package, I say, well, you can do this and this. We have patches in Debian. You can download these from there, and this is a friendly cooperation. And in Fedora Science SIG, they are covering partly what we are doing also in Debian, made with biological applications. There's also OpenSUSE Medical. Well, this is a little bit different project. It is driven by a few people. I don't know. I tried to contact them because, what they did is copying at some point in time what we have on Debian made and putting it on their website and say, well, this is SUSE Medical, but there is no code behind it, no packages. This is not my problem. They can copy. We are providing free software, but it is a wrong strategy. It is pretending you have something without having something. And if people look at something and see, whoa, what they have, and then they look closer and see they don't have anything, they will never come back. And if they see it on our side, they see, oh, the same shit, so I'm not interested. And this is a problematic thing. And I tried to contact these people, but they didn't respond. So I have no idea about this OpenSUSE Medical. And in principle, I'm really, really try to approach that every distribution follows this path, and I try to get a friendly cooperation, because finally we are on the same side. I'm not a friend of saying my distribution is better than yours. We should try to do a friendly competition and work together, because we have other competitors than other distributions. There's also some Ubuntu Mate. I don't know really what they are doing. They are lagging behind the current Ubuntu. I don't know if it's a project installed. They have a kind of different focus, and I never was able to make some contact. I would be happy if the people would talk to us, because it would be pretty straightforward to take what we are doing in Debian and doing it Ubuntu the same way, but I can't tell more about this. And there's even the FreeSD ports for the biology stuff. While FreeBSD is something else than a Linux distribution, but they have done a lot of stuff, and it is from the amount of packages, well, they have about 80%. Some packages we don't have, and some packages they don't have in the biology field. So this is kind of interesting, because we can sometimes also can look at their page and look what might be interesting. I don't know about their user base and whatever, but it exists and is in principle a similar effort. So in conclusion, we can say that Debian Mate has by far the largest team, and this is a very important point I want to mention later, and we have also the largest amount of packages which can help you in your work. What is the purpose of blends? For me, the purpose is to make a certain topic hot, because if you have a random professional, for instance, if you are working in economics, and you can tell your colleagues there is a lot of support inside Debian for economics, they would consider using Debian. And for me, it's my motivation, because I'm working in a medical institute. As I said, I'm a physicist. I'm not really concerned to medicine, but my vision was once my institute might decide to use free software, I want to present them a full system which is ready to solve all the problems we have. And in principle, I think we are quite there. Even it's not yet that used in my institute, but it could make a lot of things easier. And this is to provide people with the things they are needing inside the distribution. This is my opinion of making the topic hot. And we just want to attract specific users. This is my idea, because Debian is a very general distribution, but many people don't know what's inside, and these specifics, just stressing what's there and telling people that are interesting things there could get a really large user base. And to actually reach this by Debian made, many universities and researchers in the biology field are using our work. They are using proxied by Ubuntu, maybe, because everything what's in Debian goes to Ubuntu or other derivatives. So they are profiting from our work, and they are really happy and joined our team. This is also important. The blends are also about teaching users and to developers how to work together with Debian, because formerly you had single package maintainers, a package maintainer for this and a package maintainer for that, and sometimes you are using several packages who are not working together. And we are trying to be a contact point that people can contact us and find some way to Debian or to solve their problems on a common place. So a blend is a way to advertise Debian in a specific work field. I'm always trying to convince people to build more blends inside Debian. Why I'm doing this? Debian Made is one of the first blends, and in principle, if you think about medicine and free software, there is a very, very small common set, because medicine is at least in Europe, I don't know if it is in Brazil, it's connected to money. I guess it's here the same. And if you have money, you don't care about the price of the software. And even if we all know that free software is not about the price, other people just think about the price and they say, medicine doesn't cost anything, it's nothing worth. And so you have a very small user base and also a lack of understanding of free software in medicine. And so, in principle, this idea from 12 years ago is a lost case, because I think you have no user base, you have no applications. Why should we actually dedicate something to medicine in Debian? And even if the chance to survive was quite low, it did survive. So if the people who are doing, say, multimedia and games, and so, which has a good chance, would apply the same methods and the same ideas as we did, they could be a lot more advanced. And I'm constantly nagging, and actually this talk is for the multimedia and games people and GIS people, and I will have a similar talk on the next Debian conference to convince them that this is a good way, which you need to invest some time to build this infrastructure, but the time you gain in terms of new people who are working with you is a lot larger, and it is really worth the effort. And I can prove this. It just shows how to form a team based on Debian specific topics, the Debian Meet team. I will show you the graphs. I did some graphings. And Debian Meet just pushes, as I said, Debian into a field of dominant proprietary software. These are the main points why I think Debian Meet could be a model for other blends. So our goal is just to turn Debian into the distribution of choice for all medical fields. Yeah. From my perspective, as a coder, it's always convincing not to talk about things, but to show code and show people that things are easy. And so one technique of the blends is to create meta packages. A meta packages is nothing else than a package you can install which contains dependencies from other packages. So if you say, well, I want to prepare my computer for medical practice, there is one meta package. It is called MedPractice, and for instance, it depends from GnuMed. We have a talk about this soon. Or if you want to do medical imaging, you say install MedImaging. And then you have all the packages inside Debian which are only slightly connected to medical imaging on your computer. This is a one-click thing or one-liner. And this is a kind of technique we are using. This is kind of this magical lens on the Debian package pool I've shown you. You have installed one single package and your box is prepared and you can show what's there. This is done in the so-called blends dev package which I have developed. And we have a so-called web sentinel. I will show you later on the web what this is. These are web pages which are presenting the content of these tasks inside the meta packages in the web. And they are presenting the description of the package. They are presenting how many people are using it. They are presenting a screenshot and so on. And what's actually really important, they are also presenting translations. Because in my opinion, it is hard to translate specific descriptions. As I said, I'm a physicist. I'm reading a description of a biology package, and I don't know what it's doing. So, but this page is attracting biologists, and they are potentially understanding this. And then there's a button, and you can translate it. I will show you later. And this is a kind of technique where I think here can users provide input to something which is relevant also for other users, because these translations later on make their way into the Debian package for other users. And we have in this so-called web sentinel also bugs pages. This is for developers, because if you say, well, I'm a biologist, if I want to support Debian, I'm interested in this kind of packages, and then you have a set of everything what is relevant for you and you can focus on this work. Then we can handle scientific citations. Maybe I show you now really what I... Is this working? Yeah. Because you easily can see what I mean. For instance, if I go to the biology part, then you can see here, this is a so-called web sentinel. I hope this is not so good for this resolution. And here you find packages with citations. Here's the author and the name, and you have a link. So if a scientist sees that we are presenting in Debian, he sees citations and he gets another Google hit for his work, he's just happy because, that's interesting. And by doing so, these authors are quite motivated to support our work in packaging their software, which in turn has the effect that my own work moved from building Debian packages to teaching people how to build Debian packages. And this is a quite interesting shift, because we get a lot of people in the team because it's simply interesting for them. It's attractive to become a member of Debian Meet. We do also some subsectioning of, well, these DDPO pages. This is a technical term for quality insurance. It's probably not so interesting in this audience. And we have the ultimate Debian database, which has information about anything inside Debian. And in Debian Med, we popped this up with some additional information we need with the citation, for instance, and with things we are using on our pages. So our work in our blend influenced the whole Debian work. And this is also what I mean with a model blend, because we are giving a good part of our work back to for all other teams inside Debian. We also have written a policy. A policy is a document how we behave in the team, how the VCS is structured, and how newcomers can work together with us. Just some document other teams can copy and adapt to their needs. We also invented the mentoring of months. Mentoring of months is a thing. Well, I said I moved my work from doing the technical work myself to teaching people. And I learned that some people are showing up and say, well, I want to do something, and then they vanish again. And what could I do against this? In the business world, it's easy. The boss says, please do something, otherwise you don't get any money. I have not have this handle. And I thought about what's my handle I could have. And the only handle I have to newcomers is that I can dedicate my spare time and trade education and trade knowledge. And I said, well, I trade my knowledge for your time. You are working on this package. And so for 1 month, this student, so-called student, can ask every question. Everything is in public on the mailing list to learn how we work together. I hate private conversation because it doesn't help others who want to have to solve the same problems. So I'm doing this mentoring, and we had some successful uploads on the end of this month, or we had some very good progress in packaging. So this is an interesting thing to provide knowledge, and I hope that other teams would adapt this mentoring of months. And recently I also noticed that the blends concept is way too less popular inside Debian. And people in Debian are frequently seeking for sponsoring. Sponsoring works like a non-Debian developer has created a package but has no upload rights and needs some developer to do this. And I said, well, if your package is in the focus of any blend, of GIS, multimedia, games, whatever, and you confirm that you have understand the blend's concept, and your package is mentioned on this web sentinel of your blend, I will sponsor your package. And so I try to attract people that they understand the concept behind it and push other blends as well. In the sense, Debian Med is a model blend. Yeah. Further, we have also learned that Debian Med is in principle good for Debian, because I made some questionnaire, and in Debian Med are 23 Debian developers and Debian maintainers. And 10 of these DDs, Debian developers, confirmed that they are only Debian developers because Debian Med exists. So, in other words, it was over 10 years, or when Debian Med turned 10 years, in every year we have one Debian developer because Debian Med exists, which would be not there otherwise. And 7 out of these 10 developers extended their activity to something else inside Debian. They do not necessarily only Debian Med work, but do something else which is worth for the whole project. And 8 of these 10 developers are continually to be active. 2 of them even moved to something else, doing something else in Debian, which is fine, because we are a root project, and without Debian in itself, Debian Mate would be nothing. So as I have promised, I have some graphs where I think I can prove that Debian Mate is a healthy project. What I did here is checking the, as I said, the ultimate Debian database about who uploaded packages which are in the focus of Debian Mate. And you see in the first 5 years, well, that's me basically, and Aaron has only a single package, but is quite important. And in the year 2006-07, some more people came. And then the progress we made, were more and more, and we are more and more people. It's not important that my peak is keeps on being the highest one. The important thing is that we don't lose people. You see, the base is dense, and other people are very active. And I also want you to notice that in 2011, some quality changed. It has become even higher. And I have an explanation for this, and I will show you other graphs. You will see the same effect. This is people who are discussing on the Debian Mate mailing list. Here are some different people showing up. For instance, the third frequent poster is Carsten Hilbert. This is a developer of GNU-Mate. As I said, you can hear the talk. It's in another auditorium, but it's about GNU-Mate. This is also the connection to users. So in principle, the first 3 years, we had some discussion between me and upstream developers, and also Sebastian Hilbert in the item 8 is also GNU-Mate developer. So this is a connection between users, and you see we have also a positive development of these graphs, and in the same way, since 2011, something happened there. Yeah, this is about fixing bugs in Debian packages. This is also the same effect that in the beginning it was basically me, and then people came along and started working together with us to make Debian Mate a success. And in 2011, something happened. This is about the commits in our VCS. So when we prepare packages, we are doing this in a common either SVN or Git. This started in 2005, that's why the graph is not longer. Interesting, the last entry, Thorsten, this is actually not a Debian, not a medical person also, like me, and he has also no interest in medicine, but he said, hey, you are a cool team, I will join you. And he's just committing to our stuff and fixing bugs, and this is also really cool. And now I want to give the explanation why we see also here the change in 2011. This is when we started our first meeting. This is where we met together, where we found about 20 people of Debian Mate and others, users and whatever. And we met since 2011 and 2012, well, 2013 is not yet full. And this made a new quality, because we had a face-to-face connection, we invited new people, and I think this is something you can learn, so you should meet in your teams. Yeah, this is what I wanted to show with these graphs. So we have a positive development, we are not really losing people, and we should meet. Oops, this was wrong. Well, and if I speak about this Thorsten who just joined our team, for me, a team is waking up in the morning and realizing that somebody else has solved your problem from yesterday. And this is really, I experienced this myself, because when I was alone, it was rather frustrating. I had fun to solve problems. But it's even funnier if other people solve your problems. And this is currently happening now, because a lot of people are joining. And this is some experience other Debian teams are not usually finding. There are teams, they are working in this way, For instance, I think in Debian Perl it is similar, but in these other blends, they are a little bit understuffed because they do not focus that much on bringing people together and following this path of providing technology, using technology to bring people together. Here you can see some graph about what we actually have in Debian, Debian Meet. We have, as I said, different tasks. You see the dark blue is the biology task. These are more than 100 packages, and you see, also here you can see the 2011 meeting peak, right? And in the next row you can see the blue biology development, if you want to develop biology applications. Then you have a light blue and a light green, it's about imaging and imaging development, where we have also quite a strong focus. And as I said to you in the yellow line, it is practice management. Debian Meet contains practice management, but it's not the main point. I would like it to make it more stronger. We are working on this. We have currently 3 practice management systems inside, but there is not so much in principle. Like we will not reach the number as in the other fields. That's clear, but. There could be some more support, and yesterday I talked about hospital management systems, about Vista, and we really, really want to support hospital management, and we are close to get this happen, and I hope in the next Debian release, which is maybe 1.5 years or 2 years, I don't know, then we hopefully have it. And we have something in psychology and some tools and something else, which I did not craft here to not confuse you too much. So, after all, we can say, in the first time, we have some stagnation in the process because it was a one-man team and not so covered by people. But as you have seen on the graphs, the project was growing in all measures I have shown. It was by the number of people who are doing different work, who are talking about problems, who are solving problems. We have a number of packages, so it's actually worth doing so. And I have also a warning for you, because if you think more people means less work for you, no, that's wrong. It just shifts the kind of work you have. As I said, my work is now more teaching, coordinating, influencing other people's, but it's interesting. So try to increase your team, bring more people on your side, and this is a good idea. So my strategy is to make Blends tools even more attractive, to make Debian Meet more attractive to users and developers, because I see Debian kind of a missing link between users and developers. We have strong connections in both sides, and this link is missing usually. And I also want to make the Blends technique more attractive inside Debian, as I said. Well, this talk is available on my talks page. And you find it also if you Google for Andreas Tille talks, it is easy to find. And now I want to show you a little bit more about this Blend Sentinel, except if you have some burning question now, you can answer this, or I go and show you a little bit on the webpage. Just interrupt me if you have some questions.
A friend of mine, I'm from Uruguay, and a friend of mine works on the health field for the government, and they are studying solutions for some problems, and they find that there are proprietary software that has they have no way to find something free with their requirements, because they require that it's not enough to have the software. You need a company to support it, and you need things like this, that software and community and Debian is not enough. How do you cope with that kind of things?
The problem is, in Debian we can only bundle software that exists. So if no free software exists, we don't have the manpower to write some software. So if you can convince some company to write the software and release the code for free, this would be your turn. We could try to write some email, but this is we can't do more. If this free software would exist, we could bundle it in Debian and provide it for the user as an easy installation way. But probably we are not the right people to talk to in this situation, sadly.
And then how do you, do you have connections with companies, local companies in countries for supporting the system for hospitals and things like this?
I couldn't say yes to this. I assume and I hope that companies are using what we are providing. I really hope this. But there is no way for us to really know, because it's free. You can download it. People are downloading it and using it. And it's not really a company, but this is a derivative from Ubuntu. It's called Spio Linux. They are finally profiting from our work and now learned to put back something, but it's probably not what in the direction you are asking into. So it would be nice if there would be companies who would give some return what they are doing and they are working together with us. I would really, really like this, but currently, unfortunately, not.
Okay, and I wanted to make another question. Do you have something like a distro for medical stuff, or do you have only tasks?
Well, it's if medical stuff downloads Debian, then it's everything included, and you install this meta package, and then it's done. You could do what you can do. There is Debian Live project, and the Debian Live project enables you to create live CD or also installable live CDs, and you can say, please pick these packages for me. And if you just pick the medical packages you need, just as a meta package, you can create a live CD in half an hour or so. This is probably helpful. I really, really wish somebody would do this for us, but nobody has just done it, and I have a lot of other stuff. It's interesting, but somebody needs to do it. Yeah, but it's possible and it is easy. I can't say more. Any other questions?
Hello. Oh, here. There is an initiative or contact with companies developing medical equipment.
Yes, there are companies with medical equipment, but they usually, in the most cases, they have closed software for their stuff. And I had once a discussion with these people, or with people who are making these radiation 3D tomography devices and so. And they are very, very struck to their conventional proprietary thinking. And I made possibly some suggestions I thought were interesting. Interesting and implementing things are different things. We have a movement specifically in mass spectroscopy, which is kind of interesting because also this you have a device and the software is crap, and you need to use this crap. Yes, it is. I'm quoting people, and it's not my experience because I don't working. And finally, if you have crap from day to day, you start doing something, and these people try to replace some software, and it's only working on certain machines, on their machines, and so, and you need to find out yourself. You can, we have, and for this case, we have contact points. If you have a very specific thing, you can try to contact us. And also in medical imaging, there is some DICOM implementation, which is free software, which is quite advanced and quite usable, and people are using it. Yes, but the situation is becoming better, but it's not really good.
Okay, I actually work on a company that develops equipment here in Brazil. I would love to enter in contact and try to pitch the free software idea to my boss.
What is developed here in Brazil is Invesalius, you might know. There will be also talk about 3D. I think you can tell it more than me. It is developed here in Brazil and supported by the government. Correct me if I'm wrong.
What?
Invesalius is supported by the government from Brazil, right?
Yes.
And this is also in Debian Med. We work together with, it is also kind of a nice case because Thiago, whatever, is an upstream developer of Invesalius, and we contacted him, do you want a package, and I teach him a little bit and corrected it. And so now we have Invesalius inside Debian, so you can say, apt-get install Invesalius, and you are done. And this is what we are trying to approach for everything what is useful in medical care. So if anybody has its own project and has no idea how to distribute it, we are your contact point. Just come to us and come to the Debian Med mailing list and say, hey, there's a cool project which is useful, blah, 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 blah. And so, and it will be done, I think so. More questions? So I can, let's look if I find Invesalius here. So, I hope you can hear me. Yeah, I wished we had a longer list here. So imaging, and you can seek for, so here we are. So, here's your task for the user. We need to upload a screenshot. You see here. It should be done. It's not that long in Debian, but if you look for applications, you like to have screenshots, right? This was for the package ITK snap. And so exactly for imaging applications, you like screenshots. Here's something to do. These tasks also tell you, hey, there's a new upstream version. Please package it. So this is everything which is yellow. It's some work to do. Yeah, I'm sorry. I tried to get the Brazilian locale, but my computer insists on German. So this means translate description. So other description here, this is German. Here you have English, and then you can click on it and this translate. And if anybody wants to help us, please click on the yellow button and do what's asking you to do. Upload screenshots, go tagging, there are dev tags. For this package you have dev tags. Dev tags say, well, it's of the field medicine imaging, has a command line interface, is a program, works with the raster image and so on. And here we need some tagging, and you can do this in the dev tags interface, and every yellow button will bring you to some place where you can actually do what needs to be done. This is also some way to get connection to the users, to involve them. And here you can see, well, the descriptions, who is maintaining the package. This is in most cases a team. And you can also see how many users are using this package. This is not so much for this image with.
It is, we have not yet any users for Inversarius. Well, it's quite new. There will be more users coming up soon, and others are. So if you see how many users using a package, you can also, that's also some relevant information. So as I said, this Web Sentinel is something which gives you some information about Debian Mate and the team. And actually, if you have some non-Linux users, I think it's quite impressive. If I see 50 packages which are able to solve their problems, ready to install with one click, I think this is quite convincing for people. And these pages are also made to change your operating system, whatever it is before, you know. So this page is for my colleagues who were asking me, what are you doing? And this actually, this was the main motivation to invent these pages, to say what I'm doing. And so my time is over, and I have shown you what I'm doing. Thank you for your attention. It was fun to be here.
I will follow you.